In this module, we're going to talk about carboxylic acids, just what they are, water, some properties of water in terms of acids and bases, and pH, what it is and how to calculate it. All right, so let's start out with carboxylic acids. In general, a carboxylic acid has this formula here. This R here represents either hydrogen or one or more carbons with maybe some other elements attached to it. But what makes something a carboxylic acid is this group here, CO2H. If you expand that out, CO2H looks like this. It's a carboxylic acid group. And now this R is over here. It could be hydrogen. It could be CH3. It could be a lot of things. That's what a carboxylic acid is. Now let's look at one that you're familiar with. Acetic acid. CH3CO2H. And this is how it's acting as an acid in aqueous solution. The acidic proton, the proton that comes off, is the one that's attached directly to an oxygen. Two resonance forms, right? This one, and then the one with the double bond down here and the single bond up here, stabilizing the negative charge of the conjugate base. Now let's compare that to chloroacetic acid. Chloroacetic acid is very similar to acetic acid, except one of the hydrogens on this carbon out here, the methyl group, has been replaced with a chlorine. So let's compare these two. The conjugate base of each of these acids has the same number of resonance forms too, so that's not going to come into play. Which of these two acids, acetic acid or chloroacetic acid, do you think is more acidic? Right, chloroacetic acid. The reason is this chlorine is inductively withdrawing the electrons away from the oxygens with the negative charge in the conjugate base, stabilizing the conjugate base, making it easier to form, making the acid a stronger acid than regular old acetic acid. Now let's talk about water and its autoionization. So when you take two water molecules and you put them together, once in a while, one of them will act as an acid and the other as a base. So do you guys see what's happening here? Is one of these water molecules, it doesn't matter which, is donating a proton to the other. The one that accepts the proton becomes the hydronium ion. The one that donated the proton becomes hydroxide. And this is an equilibrium. And at equilibrium, there's not very many of these around. Mostly, it lies very far to this side. Matter of fact, we can write down an equilibrium constant expression for this. Well, this is a heterogeneous equilibrium because there's the liquid over here, so we don't write those. The K for this, the equilibrium constant expression, which we call KW, W for water, is just equal to this right here. And it ends up that at 25 degrees Celsius, the value of KW is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14th. Memorize that number. And if it's pure water, nothing else in there, then the concentrations of hydrogen ion and hydroxide are the same, and they're 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7th. Now, that is true for pure water. If it's any aqueous solution, other stuff is in there, it doesn't matter. This is still true. KW is still 1 times 10 to the minus 14th. But the hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion concentrations may not be the same as each other. If they are, that's called a neutral solution. But if the hydrogen ion concentration is greater than the hydroxide ion concentration, that's what we call an acidic solution. If the hydrogen ion concentration is less than the hydroxide ion concentration, it's a basic solution. Now, pH. This right here is how you calculate the pH of the solution. Just take the negative log base 10 of the concentration of hydrogen ion. We have a similar property called pOH. It's calculated by taking the negative log base 10 of the concentration of hydroxide ion. The inverse of these functions is 10 to the power. So if we solve this guy up here for just the concentration of hydrogen ion, we get 10 to the minus pH, and the same thing for hydroxide ion with pOH. Memorize all this stuff. This is very useful. Use it all the time in acid-base stuff. Now, remembering that KW is equal to this expression here and is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14th, if we take the log of both sides of this equal sign here, this and this, one of the properties of logs is that the log of A times B is equal to the log of A plus the log of B. If we take the log of both sides, we get this. Do it, make sure you guys get the same thing. But this is a real good thing to remember too. pH plus POH is equal to 14.00 at 25 Celsius, which we're pretty much always gonna be dealing with. All right, so one example real quick. Let's say we have a solution whose concentration of hydroxide ion we know, 0.315 molar. What is the pH of that solution? Well, there's a couple of ways you can approach this. I think the easiest way is this. We know the concentration of hydroxide, so we can calculate the pOH, negative log base 10 of the concentration of hydroxide. And when you do that, you get about 0.502 or so. And pH is just 14 minus pOH, right? Because pH plus pOH equals 14. So if we subtract this number here from 14, we get 13.50, and that's the pH.